Slobodan Milosevic, former president of Yugoslavia and Serbia, is now in the dock. The first head of state to be tried by an international court for war crimes and genocide. Milosevic had driven whole communities from their homelands to make way for his fellow Serbs. His forces had murdered thousands of civilians. The wars he provoked launched the term ethnic cleansing. And they tore Yugoslavia apart. First Croatia and Slovenia, then Bosnia and Macedonia broke away, leaving Serbia dominant in a much reduced Yugoslavia. In December 1995, the same Milosevic, who had been called the Butcher of the Balkans, was welcomed to Paris to sign the treaty that brought peace to Bosnia and the region. Everyone at the ceremony knew that only Milosevic could prevent further Serb aggression. He was the linchpin of the peace.
I didn't have a problem with talking to him. He was quite confident and said he was glad this was over and looked forward to better relations. And I said that I did too. It would depend upon how the Bosnian peace took hold and whether the oppression and killing ended.
Ja sam siguran da je pred nama puna normalizacija odnosa između Jugoslavije I Sjedinjenih Država I jedna intenzivna saradnja.
Back home in Serbia, Milosevic was a hero.
Nije bilo mnogo priče, jednostavno zaista iskrene čestitke za postignut sporazum u Daytonu, ne samo sa moje strane.
Even his wife Mira, a strong supporter of communist China and Cuba, welcomed his newfound friendship with the West.
Da sam smatrala I da sam o tome govorila svima oko sebe, dakle uopšte takva je bila atmosfera u kući. Da evo, nadamo se skinuće nam sankcije, nema više rata, otići će izbjeglice ili će jedan veliki broj njih otići. Moći ćemo da gradimo, tako da kažem, jedan svet kroz veliki oporavak I kroz novi koncept razvoja.
Most of the sanctions imposed during the Serbs' war against Bosnia had been lifted. To get the West to lift the rest of them, Milosevic had to prove he was a democrat. His opportunity came a year later in local elections.
Uspeh lokalnih izbora u Srbiji predstavljaće veliki doprinos ostvarenju razvojnog programa.
That night he got a shock. Against all predictions, the opposition defeated him in 17 of Serbia's largest towns and cities. The next day, Milosevic confided in one of his coalition partners.
Rekao je da im je saopštio kako se raduje što su izgubili I da naprotiv da će mu to samo poboljšati imidž u međunarodnoj zajednici I da niko više neće moći da mu kaže eto kako smo nedemokratska zemlja kada je to prestonicom upravlja gradonačelnik iz redova opozicije.
Svakome ko radi u interesu građana želim uspeh, a dobro je I da opozicija počne trlja glavu sa tim problemom.
This acceptance of defeat by Milosevic's party spokesman horrified the activists.
Prosto je to bio signal da se veliki broj ljudi javi I ukaže na niz nepravilnosti tokom biračkog procesa. Ja sam tražio da kod predsjednika Miloševića sastanak imali smo ponovo Ukazao sam mu na to.
Ključni moment se dogodio uveče u 20 časova kada ga je Mira pitala da li je to istina da on fašistima, četnicima, kakav je već vokabular njenih reči, želi da preda vlast. Tada ga je izgrdila i napala i onda kreće njegova promjena odluke.
Slobodan and Mira's marriage was a political partnership that had begun in high school. A politician in her own right, she had pushed him to take power in 1987. Now she led a small party of her own, a member of the coalition that had just lost the local elections.
Pa ja sam čula da ti izbori nisu objektivno se okončali sa rezultatima koji su javnosti prikazani. Možda je bilo i potkupljivanje. Znate, postoje na različite načine da se izbori, da se falsifikuju izbori, da se prikažu rezultati drugačijim.
Uticaj i pritisak jugoslovenske levice i same gospođe Marković je bio veoma veliki, tako da u toku te noći i sutradan sigurno da je napisan čitav niz, stotine i stotine žalbi su napisane za pojedina izborna mesta, da bi to imalo nekakvu zakonsku formu i da bi naši sudski organi donosili odluke kakve su doneli. Mislim da je potpuno jasno da se želilo po svaku cenu da se zadrže izbori.
Milosevic now set out to use courts he controlled to reverse the opposition's victories. He reckoned without the actions of a tiny group of people in the city of Niš. Niš had been a Milosevic stronghold for a decade. On election night, his party was so confident they'd already planned the victory celebration.
Ali tamo neki posle 2-3 sata već se videlo da socijalistička partija počela da gubi. Mogu da tvrdim da je iz Beograda naređivano da mora se pobedi. Mogu da kažem da je to Šajinović 5-6 puta zvao. To znam sigurno. Da je Krivokapić neki naš tamo naređivo moramo, ajmo junaci, ajmo ovo. Tako da, to je stvarno istina.
Their problem was that at most polling stations, the votes had already been counted.
Na kraju te ljude je vatala panika kad već nije moglo da se stisne rezultat. Jer ti su ljudi nešto odradili, neki ti odbačeni naši ljudi, neki deo posla da dođe do neke panike. A posle kad su uhvatili paniku, onda se dešavalo i ovo najprljavije što se vidi sad.
So what they did was intercept the results before they were delivered, along with the bags of ballot papers, to the election commission. But a copy of each result had also been given to the opposition's representatives on the commission.
Ja držim kopije zapisnika sa pravim rezultatima. U izbornoj komisiji se čitaju neki sasvim drugi rezultati. Ja gledam svoju kopiju, kažem, ovo nešto nije u redu.
As more results were read out, a pattern emerged.
Ukupan broj ljudi koji su izašli na birališta nije promenjen. Ali je promenjen rezultat tako što je našem kandidatu oduzeto 300 glasova, a njihovom je dodato 300. Ili 500 ili 800, zavisi od toga koliko je bilo potrebno da u ukupnom zbiru njihov kandidat pobedi. Svoje zapisnike tresnemo sto i kažem, gospodo, vi ste uhvaćeni u krađi.
The majority of the commission, Milosevic supporters, dismissed her objection. And without the falsified papers, she could not prove the fraud. All the opposition could do was protest. They soon brought the city to a standstill. The police prepared for a showdown.
Video kordone policije i to onako obučeni u onoj panci, sve po bočnim ulicama koje se graniče sa opštinom. Znam da mi je sin sa demonstrantima, onda sam rešio da nešto preduzmem.
After 22 years of loyal service to Niš City Council, the committee clerk now risked everything. Enlisting the help of two colleagues, he set out to steal the falsified papers. The main doors to the committee room, where the election results were kept, were under 24-hour police guard. But a balcony, accessible from the floor above, provided another way in.
Ja u tašni poneo konopac i kroz tu salu sa gornjeg sprata ušli na balkon. Dogovorili se, ovaj jedan kolega malo tako bršavi, najlakše za spuštanje i za dizanje, i njega spustili po mraku dole.
They dared not turn on the lights, but the clerk had told his colleague precisely where the incriminating papers were.
U toj situaciji iščekivanje je kao večno zveluje. Kao što ga nema, gde će dalje, našao, dalje otišao. I onda odjedared za nas, da kažem, katastrofa, šok. Čujemo tresak jedan. E sad, verovatno to nije bilo toliko strašno, ali u onoj tišini noći, kao da je bomba pala.
In fact, it was only a chair.
I sad iščekujemo, slušamo da li će pucnjava da se desi, da li milicija, šta je, mislim, ništa, tišina, mrtva i dalje posle tog treska. On daje znak da je došao, mi ga izvlačimo, on sav jadan, premro od straha, preznojen, šta je bilo.
But he had brought out the falsified papers. They showed how crudely the voting figures had been changed. If the theft was discovered, Milosevic's party would have the grounds they wanted to get the elections annulled. So the clerk had planned to return the papers after photocopying them. But his accomplice lost his nerve.
Kaže, ja ne idem to da vratim, pa tamo možda me ubesite. I onda je jedino rešenje da te originale vratim. Ja lično drugog izbora nisam imao ili neko bolje rešenje nisam našao. U 9 došao predsednik, milicioner otvorio vrata. I vidim ispod oka, gledam, oni svi nešto razgovaraju, ja to metem onako diskretno tamo gde je bilo.
He took his photocopies to the local opposition leader.
Ja pitao kako, pitao da ja nešto tražim, ja sam rekao ništa ne tražim. Nadam se jedino, odnosno tražim da vi to iskoristite kako treba.
The opposition tried to get the local media to report this scandal, but Milosevic's party controlled all television and radio in Niš. Then the opposition got another break.
Vlasnik televizije Najs je pozvao ljude u koaliciji zajedno i rekao je: ja ovo više ne mogu da trpim, ovakve laži na državnoj televiziji, evo ja vam dajem u vreme drugog televizijskog dnevnika da dođete na moju televiziju i da kažete šta se stvarno dešava.
TV Najs's normal fare was pirated videos and dancing girls, but now it got serious. Mrs. Zivkovic was chosen to put the evidence before the voters.
Čuvena ženska dilema, aha, ima malo vremena, da li da ja idem da operem kosu ili da malo proverim te svoje podatke, ipak ću se ja doterati, a podaci su sveži.
Mi smo videli da su primjerci zapisnika iz kojih se čitaju rezultati na najgrublji način falsifikovani, tako što su
građani Niša tada mogli da prvi put jasno vide šta se te noći desilo i videli na koji način su socijalisti pokrali izbore.
Students from Niš walked 140 miles to Belgrade to demand justice. While they were on the road, The local court ruled that the opposition had won the election in Niš. When the students faced Milosevic, he was charm itself and readily promised to chase down the election cheats.
Budite sigurni da ste samim dolaskom kod mene napravili korak da se sigurno i to sasvim sigurno obezbedi legalitet.
He could afford to be magnanimous over Niš because everywhere else the courts had already ruled in favor of his coalition. Since then, the opposition had been protesting throughout Serbia. The victory in Niš gave them new hope.
Osjećalo se odmah da se nešto prelomilo u Srbiji po toj atmosferi. Svih tih dana su bile delimično niske temperature, padala je ponekad kiša, ponekad sneg. Svaki dan sve više je bilo ljudi. To više nisu one uobičajene demonstracije koje je opozicija od 90. godine neuspešno organizovala, nego da je tu već jedan veliki pokret, pokret za demokratske promene.
Night after night, the protests grew.
That was all the time the situation to tell people, just don't use any violence, don't even step on the grass, you know, so that we don't be blamed for anything. Of course, we use some eggs, you know, not more than that.
Milosevic and his brand of nationalism remained popular with older voters. His wife refused to believe young people had really turned against him.
Jasno je meni bilo da je to sve smišljeno i realizovano izvan Jugoslavije. Neko je toj deci, mladim ljudima, mogao da nanese tu traumu, da oni napuste fakultete, škole, da ih vuče po ulicama beogradskim danima, noću, po zimi i tako dalje, da im daje drogu, da ih potkupljuje stranim novcem. Neko ko nije iz ovog naroda.
Uvek i njeno rukovodstvo, Julovsko, zastupali su da treba drastičnim merama raščistiti sa demonstracijama. Vrlo često Milošević je to prećutkivao, saslušavao, nešto preduzimao, ne preduzimao, ali uglavnom ona se nije uopšte kolebala.
After weeks of daily protests, Milosevic was persuaded to take a huge gamble. His party prepared a counter-demonstration in the heart of the capital.
Sigurno da su postoje ljudi kojima je možda taj dan trebao da bude u funkciji stvaranja novih problema u Srbiji, stvaranja nereda, možda čak i stvaranja uslove da Srbija uđe u nekako vanredno stanje kako bi se možda svi ovi nesporazumi rešili.
The state of emergency would enable the regime to call out the army and, crucially, ban future demonstrations. On the 35th day of the protests, Milosevic supporters were given the day off on full pay and brought to Belgrade.
Odbranimo ono što treba da se odbrani i što je stvorio Slobodan Milošević i što će postojati samo dok je Slobodan Milošević na vlasti.
Da podržimo našeg predsjednika pod našim zastavom. Da. To je naš.
Leaders of the ruling coalition gathered at a hotel in the city center.
Kako su rasle tenzije, očigledno da je bilo prisutno tu jedno izuzetno militantno jezgo iz same jugoslovenske levice, spremno na sve moguće vrste sukova. Čak su to javno i govorili u samoj Moskvi.
I tu smo se sakupili, tu smo čekali da idemo na miting. Miting je trebao da počne, ja mislim, negde oko 12 sati. I moj muž je trebao da govori na tom mitingu.
The opposition had 80,000 demonstrators on the streets that day, outnumbering Milosevic's supporters by 2-1.
Taj jedan narod koji je doveden iz unutrašnjosti nikakvu predstavu nije imao šta se događalo u Beogradu, jer je Milošević manipulisao preko medija. RTS naravno ništa nije prikazivo, a i ono što je prikazivo to je bila mala grupa, rulja, razularene bande.
From the moment they set foot in Belgrade, Milosevic's supporters were set upon by the opposition.
Ljudi koji su došli u Beograd su bili bukvalno žrtvovani, ljudi iz unutrašnjosti.
And someone had ordered the police to keep off the streets.
Zvao Nebojšu Čovića, gradonačelnika, i pitao sam ga: Nebojša, šta se ovo događa? Nigde nema milicije, nama batinaši iz opozicije napadaju naše građane.
Što sam u moj centar za obaveštavanje u Skupštini grada, gde postoje kamere koje pokrivaju ključne raskrsnice i ključne delove Beograda, sve to bilo isključeno. Nigde na ulici nisam video policajca kada sam prešao. Telefonirao sam potom Radovanu Stojčiću, tadašnjem načelniku resora javne bezbednosti ili pomoćniku ministra za javnu bezbednost, i pitao ga što se to događa, zašto je to tako. On mi je rekao da je lično Slobodan Milošević zabranio da policija izađe.
At 1:30, a Milosevic supporter shot an opposition demonstrator in the head. Back at the hotel, Milosevic's wife called for action.
I u jednom trenutku mi je čak i gospođa Marković rekla: šta čekate, trebalo bi aktivirati vojsku Jugoslavije da se ovo sve razbije, da se završi i tako dalje. Vrlo se dobro sećam da sam tada rekao gospođi Marković: molim vas, smirite se, nema nikakvih razloga, vojska ni u kom trenutku neće imati nikakvo učešće na ulicama Beograda.
As president of Yugoslavia, Lilić had the authority to declare a state of emergency and call out the army. Milosevic could call in the police to stop the violence, but he wanted a state of emergency, so he still refused.
Ja sam nazvao Miloševića i pitao sam ga zašto to radi. On je počeo da vrišti, da se dere kao kukavice, plašite se. Znaš, sam mi rekao: Slobodane, dogovorili smo se da policija bude i da ne dozvolimo da dođe do obračuna.
The mayor of Belgrade was a crucial ally of Milosevic, but the violence on his streets was stretching his loyalty to breaking point.
Na sve to sam ja Milošević odgovorio da ima rok od 20 minuta, da ukoliko u tom roku ne dobijemo policiju koja treba da uđe da razdvoji građane, da bi se izbegao građanski rat, ja silazim dole i preći ću na stranu ljudi koji učestvuju u protestu. On mi je spustio slušalicu, ali posle 15 minuta me je zvao Radovan Stojčić i rekao da ima nalog i odobrenje da policija uđe.
Soon after, the riot police set about closing off the main square to allow Milosevic to speak in safety. He blamed the weeks of demonstrations on the usual suspects.
Građani Srbije, jaka Srbija nije po volji mnogih moćnika izvan naše zemlje. Zato su oni u sprezi sa petom kolonom koju formiraju ovde pokušali da našu zemlju destabilizuju, da je oslabe.
His supporters lapped it up. But his objective that day had not been achieved. As demonstrators struggled home, Milosevic and his close advisors held a post-mortem. His wife berated them for allowing the police to stop the clashes too soon.
U jednom trenutku je gospođa Marković veoma se dobro sećam rekla, evo ja ću upotrebiti najblažu formu tog izraza, niste pravi muškarci. Je gospođa Marković rekla, pa morate da budete svesni da se vlast ne može predati tako lako, da se ne predaje bez krvi.
The chance to declare a state of emergency had been missed. The opposition resumed their peaceful demonstrations, which now became unstoppable. On the 78th day of the protests, Milosevic finally gave in. He pushed through a special law to overrule his courts and give the opposition their election victories. Zoran Djindjic became the mayor of Belgrade, and the opposition took power in another 14 of the largest towns and cities in the country. More than half of Serbia's population now found themselves living under opposition-controlled local councils. Milosevic's grip on power had been loosened. But when in trouble, he had always known how to win Serb votes. He played the nationalist card. He had come to power a decade before by championing the cause of the Serb minority in Kosovo.
Kosovo nije jedan običan deo Srbije. Kosovo je samo srce Srbije. Čitava naša istorija je na Kosovu. Svi naši manastiri su na Kosovu.
Serbia's claim to its southern province of Kosovo dates back over 700 years. By Milosevic's time, 9/10 of those living there were not Serbs, but ethnic Albanians. They had long enjoyed substantial autonomy, but Milosevic had shut down Kosovo's parliament and stripped the Albanians of their political rights. A small group of Kosovo Albanians responded by setting up the Kosovo Liberation Army, the KLA. In 1996, they set out to attract the world's attention.
Ne jemi takuar në Prishtinë, jo larg nga këtu. Ne natyrisht tu mbledhëm, diskutuam. Ndërkombëtarët nuk do të interesohen fare për Kosovën, por që se ne nuk lëvizëm vetë. Dhe ndërkombëtarët do të lëvizim vetëm atëherë kur ne lëvizëm dhe ne krijojmë realitete që ndërkombëtarët e interesohen për Kosovën. Njerëz kemi pasur më tepër sa që kishëm në atë kohë armë.
U gjet një variant i mirë i cili na siguroi bomba dore, dhe të cilat shpërthyn në të kryesisht në për kampet e refugjatëve ose t'i quim kolonizatorve tri të Kosovës, në nivel të Kosovës dhe në për stacionet të policisë.
One of the grenade throwers was a law student in Kosovo's capital, Pristina.
Natyrisht dhe vendosa vendin ku mund të jetë më efektiv aksionit. Në qendrën e mjekësisë, në atë kohë nuk mësonin shqiptare. Në atë kohë ishte boshatisur shkolla dhe kishin mundshëm me refugjat. Kam dalë në rrugë dhe pikrisht aty ku unë kam pasur të kryej aksionin, edhe sot edhe atëherë kanë qenë disa kioskje të hamburgerit. I kam hodhë bomben dhe jam këthyar direkt, jam futë në kioskën hamburgerë dhe kam marrë hamburgerë. Kështu që, kur kanë ardhë policia tjerë që të veprojnë me drita të kaltra me shumë e shumë tjera, unë kam dalë nga hamburgeri këshumë indiferent të i hangar hamburgerë në rrugë dhe kam kalu në mes të policisë.
Tipičan primer za to su teroristički akti šiptarskih separatista na Kosmetu. Više ili manje za...
The synchronized attacks in six towns in Kosovo put the KLA on the map. But without serious weapons, they were no threat to Milosevic. Then an ill wind blew them some good. In the late spring of 1997, the government in neighboring Albania collapsed. Anarchy followed.
Nxjerr prej depove dhe njerëzit kanë vjedhë, kanë qenë nëpër shtëpitë e tyre. Sikur të kishin pas njerëzit tonë të përqendruar. Gjatë thymjes së depove në Shqipëri, ne do të kishim pas mundësi edhe pa para me grumullu armatime të shumta atje. Pak me vones, por kemi shku, do thotë kemi ndërtu një strukturë njerëzish, për grumullimin dhe blerjen e armëve me çmime të arsyeshme atë. Dhe kemi kriju 3 depo, të cilat më vonë kanë funksionuar dhe janë tërhek për Kosovë.
To evade Serb border patrols, the KLA revived an ancient method of delivery.
Oni odvedu konje preko granice, natovare ih sa oružjem i puste ih. I oni sami znaju put i dođu kući na Kosovo, gde ih čeka organizacija koja preuzima oružje i nosi po selu. Tako da vrlo malo ubijenih, vrlo malo likvidiranih terorista je bilo u toj graničnoj liniji, jer oni jednostavno nisu išli tu. Tu su išli samo tovari.
With their new weapons, the KLA's attacks became more deadly. Milosevic's paramilitary police hit back hard.
We got a call from our correspondent, who was scared to death. He said there was this shooting taking place in the village of Likoshan.
When his photographer reached the village, he found that 20 Albanian men had been shot dead there by the Serb police.
We took photos of each and every one of them, the corpses. We decided to set up an agency on the web so we can show this to the world.
It worked. The international community now began to take notice.
Serb forces were on the rampage, and it looked exactly like the start of the ethnic cleansing in Bosnia, and you could see that the Milosevic and his cronies were looking at ways of doing it all over again, but this time in Kosovo. That's why I went to Belgrade in order to confront Milosevic with what was happening. He greeted me with elaborate courtesy. I made it plain that the present situation was one that the international community would not accept. He at once then went back to the Battle of the Field of Crows in 1389 and said that Kosovo had always been Serbian since then and it was going to remain Serbian. I did put him on the point that on that basis, you know, Britain could lay claim to large chunks of France.
I have to say that I leave with very grave concerns from what I have learnt in my day in Belgrade. In particular, I am disturbed at the reports that are reaching me that there was a further serious operation in Kosovo overnight.
He had heard that a Serb force was now targeting the home of the KLA commander-in-chief, whom they suspected of murdering several Serbs.
Demjashar ka qenë njëri i madh, ka qenë njëri trim, ka qenë njëri me vizion të qartë politik, por edhe
ka pas me të vërtetë një përvojë të madhe ushtarake.
As the Serbs approached Yashari's village, his comrades urged him to escape.
A dhe mi kishte pasën të gjuar këto fjallë, dhe thot, bënit falja bacës adem, po e kuptoj se qka jetu ke thonë. Mirë, po nëse unë do të largohëm atërë rezistenca këtu, nuk do të jetë atë aqe fuqishme sa duhet të jetë, pra ndaj unë kam vendosje të mbetem këtu, dhe do të rezistojmë dhe do të qëndrojmë deri të njeriu i fundit.
A i ka qenë kategorik se unë nuk do të leviz familje nga shtëpia, nuk do të largohi.
Adam Yashari had decided the KLA needed a martyr.
Yashari i ljudi koji su bili naoružani bili su spremni da poginu po svaku cenu. Mi smo imali problem što su oni kao taoce držali žene, decu i starce. Mi smo ih, policija ih je danima pozivala megafonom da puste taoce, da predaju oružje. Svaki sljedeći pokušaj našeg prilaska stvarao je mogućnost da u redovima policije bude još više žrtava. I iz tog razloga je bilo neophodno da se koristi jedan deo artiljerijskih sredstava.
When all firing from the Yasharis had stopped, the Serbs entered the compound. The women and children left alive were hiding in a cellar.
Bumës të qako në aja, kanë gju e kanë qitë në në zau a petë a qitë në supë. Më të ngotë i kërejtë.
She was the only survivor. Yashari and 45 of his fighters and family were killed. 12 of the dead were women. 11 were young children. Yashari's death had the effect he intended. In Pristina, 100,000 turned out in support of the KLA. Their protest was broken up by Serb police.
Professor, Union Professori Faculté.
Six foreign ministers were called to London. They were the contact group, which had been created to settle arguments between Russia and the West during Milosevic's previous wars.
What prompted Madeleine Albright and I to seek the meeting is that the longer we let this go, the worse it was going to become.
We met at Lancaster House in a room where we had met a number of times. And I said, gentlemen, remember that history is watching us, and our predecessors sat in this room and watched Bosnia burn.
The British and Americans were determined to reimpose the full range of economic sanctions against Milosevic.
У нас произошел очень тяжелый разговор с Мадлен Олбрайт. Почему вы требуете, чтобы мы бы разворачивали во все санкции? Почему мы загоняем в угол Югославию, которая идет на какие-то уступки?
The truth is, I was pretty obnoxious. I mean, I kept feeling that we had this was a crucial meeting, and that we couldn't start giving away things early.
Аргументы однозначные, что Косово.
What I pressed Yevgeny on is that we really had to be seen to respond to what was happening within Kosovo. If we really wanted to change Milosevic's thinking, the most important, useful way to do it was the commercial sanctions.
Мы тогда пытались немного охладить пыл наших западных партнеров, потому что мы понимали, что принятие санкций, на что западные партнеры уповали, чего они требовали, это может еще больше ухудшить ситуацию.
The rest of the group ignored the Russian objection and decided to impose new economic sanctions on Serbia. They told Milosevic he must start talks with the Kosovo Albanians on autonomy. Milosevic was adamant that as Kosovo was a province of Serbia, how it was ruled was a purely domestic concern.
Od trenutka Milošević jednostavno kaže za Kosovo i Metohiju ne postoje nikakve koncesije i oko toga nema razgovora.
To ram the point home, he held a referendum with a carefully formulated question. Will you accept foreign mediation in solving the Kosovo problem?
Ovo je referendum da o Srbiji odlučuje Srbija. Ja želim da poručim albanskim liderima na Kosovu. Neka se manu belosvetskih dušebrižnika koji brinu svoje, a ne njihove brige.
95% of Serbs voted as Milosevic wanted. The Kosovo Albanians boycotted the referendum. The more Milosevic dismissed their demands, the more Kosovo Albanians turned to the KLA.
We realized that we were going to have to, first of all, find out who these KLA were, and secondly, somehow try to get them into the peace process. We assumed there must be a leadership there. But it was a little like the search for the Northwest Passage.
We went out looking for people to talk to. There were roadblocks everywhere. People had put up rakes and plows and stuff just to block the roads. There was shooting in the area, but this was clearly in Albanian control.
As the Americans hoped, the KLA were tracking them and made a kind of contact in the first village they visited.
We went upstairs in the house to sit down, and we were talking to the village chief. And quite unexpectedly, a rather dashing man with a beard, carrying a weapon that looked larger than him, came and just jammed himself into the seat.
We'll come back and let you talk to us. If you want, we can talk here. We can go outside.
There wasn't a lot of room, so he practically sat on Holbrook's lap as if Holbrook were Santa Claus.
In fact, the Americans had got no nearer to the KLA top brass. But the KLA had won valuable publicity. The picture went around the world, apparently showing Americans and KLA rubbing shoulders.
And the photograph did become part of the legend of Kosovo. And it infuriated Milosevic.
Za nas je bilo izuzetno iznenađenje. Činjenica da je gospodin Holbrook dopustio sebi da skine cipele, I da bos u čarapama sedne sa teroristima I da razgovara.
The American president got an earful.
J'ai donc téléphoné à Bill Clinton, au président Clinton, pour lui faire part de mon étonnement et lui dire que je considérais que ce n'était pas là une initiative heureuse et que c'était le sentiment de l'ensemble de l'Union européenne.
But the Americans pressed on. A week later, Ambassador Holbrooke used a conference in Switzerland as a cover for another assignation.
Varej siç më tha edhe Gjavit Haliti nga ky kontakt se çfarë rjedhë do të marrë edhe përkrahja apo mos përkrahja, mbështetja apo mos mbështetja e ushtrisë shqiptare të Kosovës. Ish përgjegjësi shumë e madhe për mua.
The man the KLA had chosen to speak for them was a refugee living with his family on social security.
Shkova një orë diçka më herët se sa orë e parapar për takim. Dhe ula në restorant të këtij hoteli, isha më I riu, I panjohur për shumicën e njerëzve të shërbimeve ndryshme sekrete që ishin prezent aty. Porosita një pije, isha nervos.
We didn't know much about the KLA. Our intelligence didn't make it clear who was in charge of it, where they got their money, how it was organized, or even what they stood for.
Unë I tregova qartë se ushtria shkrimtare e Kosovës është për një Kosovë demokratike. Dhe e majta, e djathta, edhe e qendra,
si forca politike nuk mund ken kuptim në Kosovë, ku fshatnat tona bombardohen sin të majt, sin djat, sin qendër.
Asking them to exercise restraint when they were ready fighting for their lives was a difficult thing to do, and I understood that.
Më tha që në këtë procese si për, ne do t'i imponojmë fillimisht Miloševićit në ndryshimet e tila kushtetutare që 3-5 vjetë më vonë ato ndryshimet të shenë në pavarësinë e Kosovës.
I may have suggested to Mahmudi right away that that was a possibility if they handled themselves correctly.
Even if it was only a possibility, this was the best news the KLA could have heard. After the meeting, they set out to make themselves more user-friendly to the West.
Me antarët e shtabit përgjithshëm kur kom bisedu, kom kërkuar nga ata që urgjentisht të hiqen simbolet që identifikonin ushtarët tonë me komunistët ose me të hiqen fotografitë e Enverhoxhës që në disa vende dikush i kishte vënë. Të hiqen mjekrat, të hiqet grushti në përshëndetje dhe mundësisht të përshëndetet ashtu siç përshëndet ushtria amerikane.
During the summer of 1998, the KLA killed 80 Serb police and 60 civilians. They took over two towns and claimed they would soon liberate all of Kosovo. The truth was, they didn't yet have a proper army. The Serbs did. They now targeted entire villages, driving people out and burning their homes.
Kad ulazite u selo i svih kuća, veliki zidovi počne da se puca i tako dalje. Policija i vojska uvek u samoodbrani reaguje kako zna i ume da se sačuva i tako dalje. I tu je moguće da je bilo i prekoračenja.
Secretary Albright ordered me to go see Milosevic and to make it clear this absolutely had to stop. He told me that they were simply conducting operations against terrorism.
Unlike earlier emissaries, the American had traveled extensively around Kosovo.
I said, let me first tell you what I saw in Milosevo. I saw men in Serb uniforms putting television sets and other consumer goods into a trailer. I saw another man dressed in a Serb uniform with a can of liquid, spreading it in a store and lighting it with a match. At that point, he became very agitated. He stood up and began pacing, thrusting his hands in his pockets and saying, it's unacceptable, it's unacceptable.
U svim tim operacijama svi naši pripadnici i vojske i policije znali su da je izuzetno važno i imali su naredbu o tome da ni na kakav način ne smeju biti povređeni civili.
Once again, Milosevic was maintaining a statesmanlike pose while, with a nod and a wink, encouraging atrocities. This time, the procedure brought down on him the wrath of America.
I felt that we had learned something from Bosnia and had learned the terrible mistake you make once you realize you have an intransigent situation to just keep talking and fiddling around the edges. And I felt we had to move in a hurry.
J'ai dit à President Clinton qu'une intervention militaire dans un monde civilisé et organisé nécessitait un feu vert, une demande ou au moins un accord du Conseil de sécurité des Nations Unies.
Well, we'd still be there waiting if that were the case because of the distribution of power there.
It was evident that the Russians would veto a Security Council resolution and we would be paralyzed. And so what was the point of going down that road and finding that you had basically ended up in a blind alley.
The United Nations, which could authorize the use of force, adjourned for the summer without doing so. Milosevic drew his own conclusions.
Every dictator knows that if you want to up the ante, August, when the diplomats are on the beaches and when even prime ministers take holidays, is the best time to do it. And it's true that at the end of July, as people left NATO headquarters, Milosevic started sweep operations.
Serb forces had the KLA at their mercy. By mid-September, it was reported that 100,000 ethnic Albanians were hiding from the Serb police in the forests and hills of Kosovo. Russia now changed its policy. On the 23rd of September, it backed a UN resolution calling for a ceasefire in Kosovo and the return of refugees. But the resolution contained no threat of force. The very next day, NATO's defense ministers assembled by the seaside in Portugal. They came to discuss whether they could issue the threat which the UN had balked at.
Los distintos países que intervinieron, intervinieron de maneras diferentes unos de otros.
They adjourned for lunch in crisis, split a dozen ways. When they returned, the Secretary General tried to rally them.
Yo tomé la palabra y dije claramente que no podíamos salir de esa reunión sin tomar una decisión más sólida, más seria, que diera una clarísima señal a Milosevic de que las cosas no podían seguir allí. Y les dije una frase que luego fue recogida, como sigamos así, Milosevic seguirá tomando una ciudad o un pueblo cada día. La táctica de Milosevic, le dije en inglés, a village a day keeps NATO away.
The graphic reminder that if they did not act, another village would be burnt tomorrow and the day after touched a nerve. But the defense ministers still had no legal basis to threaten force.
What we needed to do there was to put in place some action to back up the United Nations resolution and to stop the horrors that were actually playing every half hour on the television that day in the hotel. I'd been holding the UN resolution, this list of demands on Milosevic. I suddenly thought, well, we have got a strategy here. And I said in my opening intervention, there's the list of demands. He has got to withdraw the number of troops, he's got to stop the disproportionate violence, he's got to do a whole variety of things laid down by the United Nations. If he doesn't do that, we know the United Nations cannot move. So NATO will move. NATO will say or else.
Und mit dieser Formel, die die Briten immer wieder in sehr eleganter, subtiler Weise eingebracht haben, ist es am Ende dann auch gelungen, die Bedenken Frankreichs zu beseitigen. Briten bauten die Brücke, über die wir dann gemeinsam gehen konnten.
Just a few moments ago, the North Atlantic Council approved the issuing of the Act 1 for both a limited air option and a phased air campaign in Kosovo.
The Secretary General's announcement meant NATO's war machine was primed. In Belgrade, Milosevic summoned his Supreme Defense Council. He faced a mutiny.
Ja sam na to rekao da mi smo dosta toga uradili, ako treba još nešto da uradimo, da uradimo i da potpuno ispunimo rezoluciju, da to objavimo i da to, da tako kažem, bude naš osnovni politički stav.
Ja sam Milošević upozoravao da će Zapad, ako se ne ispune odredbe rezolucije 1199, preduzeti mere da bombama reši problem.
Imao sam utisak da takav ton nipošto nije odgovarao gospodinu Miloševiću, pošto je on, ja mislim, bio ušao u fazu u kojoj je sumnjičio spremnost međunarodne zajednice i NATO pakta da realizuju svoje ratne prijetnje Saveznoj Republici Jugoslaviji. Naime, Miloševićevi komentari su, pa šta, dogodit će se bombardovanje, pa posle toga će opet biti mir, bit će bombardovanje 5 ili 7 dana, nakon toga će se mobilisati međunarodna zajednica, NATO pakt će morati odustati od takve svoje namjere i mi ćemo onda biti moralni pobjednici.
On je to negirao, ne vjerujući u to.
Overruling his colleagues, Milosevic dismissed NATO as a paper tiger. In Brussels, America's special envoy asked the NATO Council for a show of force to convince Milosevic they meant business.
Hello, Javier.
I request an immediate activation order. Now, an activation order means that you turn the planes over to the Supreme Commander and let him launch whenever he wants to. And it is the next to last step before the use of force.
Einige Nationen waren bereit zuzustimmen, das war klar. Andere mussten Weisung einholen und so rannten sie an ihre Telefone und versuchten in der Nacht ihre Außenminister zu kriegen, weil der Generalsekretär ein weiteres Treffen noch in dieser Nacht angesetzt hatte. Wirklich zu meiner Überraschung hatten alle Nationen die Weisung, der Activation Order zuzustimmen.
The order gave Milosevic 96 hours to comply with all the demands in the UN resolution.
We then move B-52s forward from the United States to Britain. We put planes on the runway in Aviano, gassed up and ready to go. We moved ships into the Adriatic, and we made sure that the world saw this. We were not bluffing. We were hours away from launch.
Faced with the display of force, Milosevic caved in.
Bila je uočljiva briga kod samog Miloševića, obzirom na potpuno jasnu, izraženu, neskrivenu pretnju da je bombardovanje veoma blizu.
Milosevic agreed to all the West's demands, including the withdrawal of some of his forces from Kosovo.
Mi smo to naređenje ispoštovali, morali smo da ga ispoštujemo. Jednostavno, prepustili smo jedan deo teritorije Albancima. Što su oni iskoristili? Znači, oni nisu ispoštovali prekid vatre.
We never asked the KLA to do anything. We never asked the KLA to sign anything. We simply informed them.
The balance of power in Kosovo was about to shift.
S'ka mujtë të forët atë sërbë me lëviz gjithka për Kosovë, për që shumicën e faktikisht shumë rajonet Kosovës nuk kanë qenë me, kontrol, me marveshën që kanë nëshua, sërbë nuk kanë gudzovë me hyjë dhe ne kemi pasë lirë për veprim.
Gjatë kohës jam armëpushimit, ne kemi shvetzuar shpetë shpetë që të hapim kanalet të reja të funizimit për rëgutët të rinjë dhe për pajisin ose për zëvëndësimin atë mjetëve që qëfar ishin shfridzuar dhe qëfar ishin hargjuar gjatë luftimet të ndryshme.
Ka qenë gëzimi ma, ka qenë ma shumë se ndihmë në atë ku për neve.
The international team appointed to monitor the ceasefire were powerless to stop them.
We were possibly the only people in Kosovo that didn't have arms. But there we were between these two forces trying to keep them apart. They were heavily armed, they were willing to use those arms, and eventually we worried that they would maybe turn their arms on us, thinking that we had somehow were leaning in the opposite direction.
Some of the monitors did lean, and mostly one way.
Nuk kanë dashur për matjen e zjerën e koordinatave dhe shumë gjona tjera që i vyen çdo ushtri. Është normal, amerikanët dhe anglesët kanë ndihmu më shumë.
Lucheka se croyait très fortement aidé, notamment par les Américains, et elle était très vindicative.
Na nuk kemi marrë asnjëherë në një sulm serioz sepse s'kemi pas fuqi. s'kemi pas prillat me na jetë, s'kemi pas, mirë po kemi mujt me ngasmu që ata me na sulmu neve. Edhe kështu që kemi ngasmu kryesisht me snajper, caku jo në qka da një me më rinë këtë kohë, është që nata janë ndërhynë të soma shpejt.
The Serbs rose to the bait.
A village that had one KLA member would be subject to being surrounded by artillery, being surrounded by the army, being surrounded by the police, bombarded for hours. The police units would then go in, separate the men and the boys, take them off, and essentially pillage and loot and burn in the village.
In early January 1999, the KLA shot dead three Serb policemen. The Serb response in the village of Racak would change everything.
Mi smo imali izveštaje o jednoj familiji iz sela Racak koja je bila odgovorna za ubistvo tri policajca. Dobili smo naređenje od pretpostavljene komande da pripremimo akciju za uništenje terorista koji su se tu nalazili. Mi smo u akciju krenuli u 2 sata ujutru. Vreme je bilo vrlo hladno. Zemlja je bila zaleđena. Mrak je bio. Znali smo da u takvoj akciji lavež pasa može da upropasti celu akciju. Na sreću, to malo što je ostalo, verovatno se zbog hladnoće sklonilo u neka toplija mesta. Mi smo se kretali kroz šumu i došli smo do njihovih rovova. Došlo je do kratke borbe u kojoj su naše jedinice uspele da likvidiraju te ljude koji su dežurali u rovovima. To je već bilo u osvit zore i došlo je do borbe.
For 6 hours, the paramilitary police fired into the village from one end, while army units bombarded it from the other. Then the major moved in with his police.
Vojska Jugoslavije i jedan drugi deo policijskih snaga su krenuli sa druge strane sela da potiskuju teroriste.
The Serb force reported finding the bodies of 15 Albanian men in the village. The Serb major says that after searching from house to house, he left a small unit to stand guard overnight.
I u toku noći su oni napustili položaj. Iz kog razloga to rečeno je da su se bili uplašili.
When the head of the monitoring team arrived at work next morning, one of his deputies was waiting for him.
I remember him saying, "I'm sorry, sir, but I think something else has happened up there, and it might be something pretty bad." So we drove down the highway to the village.
By the time Ambassador Walker entered the village, some KLA men had returned.
I was told that if you want to see what happened yesterday, you go up this ravine. We came on the first body. There was a little rug over the head. And as I walked up to it...
He's been beheaded?
That's affirmative, over.
I'm not sure if he was shot off or how it's off. Different pieces of skull.
Jesus Christ. There was no head on this body. It was just the neck and...
That's okay. I mean, let's give him the dignity of covering him up.
As we walked up the ravine, we kept finding one body after another.
Sorry. All right, up to here is 9.
Shoot me.
We then came on a pile of bodies, in which, I don't know, there must have been 10 to 15 bodies all piled on top of each other.
The Serb police claimed the dead were KLA members killed in the battle, and that fellow KLA men had replaced their uniforms with peasant clothes to make them look like civilians. Ambassador Walker was sure he saw evidence to the contrary.
I noticed blood-stained clothes where the bullets had entered, and the blood-stains were around the wound. I found it impossible to believe that the blood-stains had somehow been put in just the right place.
Walker decided to give the world his verdict.
From what I personally saw, I do not hesitate to describe the event as a massacre, obviously a crime very much against humanity.
I felt that what I had seen was a horror, and that it was in fact perpetrated by the security forces from Belgrade.
This was the kind of hard evidence the Americans had been waiting for. For months, the Secretary of State had been urging her allies to use force against Milosevic. Now she seized her opportunity.
It's terrible to think that something like a massacre can actually galvanize people to action. The truth is, something terrible happened, and the question then was what to do next.
I made clear that I thought this justified an immediate military response. Now, the Europeans were not ready to do that.
America's allies feared that Mrs. Albright wanted to bounce them into war. They needed a strategy of their own. France's president phoned London.
J'ai dit à Tony Blair que le premier pas dans cette nouvelle stratégie, c'était la réunion du groupe de contact. Alors pourquoi la réunion du groupe de contact? Tout simplement parce que dans le groupe de contact, il y avait la Russie.
Jacques Chirac and I were both very conscious of the fact that the Russians obviously were in a different position because of their closeness to the Serbs. And therefore we were very anxious to try and do everything we could through the contact group.
Et je savais parfaitement que Madame Albright, personne brillante, mais dont le caractère n'était pas toujours facile, était réservée à l'égard de la réunion du groupe de contact, parce qu'elle ne voulait pas siéger avec les Russes ou discuter avec les Russes. Et donc j'ai dit à Tony Blair que nous devions vaincre la réticence de Madame Albright.
The problem always was in the contact group meetings that the Western allies would say, we can't do anything because the Russians won't move. And so I went to Moscow.
In an attempt to outflank her European colleagues, she went straight to the Russian foreign minister.
When we got together, we always tried to do something nice in addition to having the hard discussions. So he had invited me to the Bolshoi. It was really an amazing scene to sit in the Tsar's box with the Russian foreign minister, and the whole place was full of red velvet and gold, and I had, I thought, a perfect outfit for this, which was also long velvet. People actually turned around to look at the two foreign ministers together. I decided to take a calculated risk to lay out our strategy that we would have to be prepared to use force. I think that Ivanov was quite surprised.
And he in turn surprised her.
Ivanov made clear that he was tired of dealing with the consequences of Milosevic's aggression. He was tired of having Russia appear always to defend Milosevic, that he agreed that if anything was ever going to work, it was going to require the use of force, but he told her quite candidly he could never say that publicly.
Having that kind of assurance, we were in a position to issue some kind of an ultimatum.
The French and British leaders were determined to prevent Mrs. Albright using the ultimatum as a shortcut to war. They wanted to use it to force Milosevic to change his policy in Kosovo.
Tony Blair m'avait invité à dîner au Downing Street. Et je lui ai dit, ben, je serais très content d'embrasser Cheryl et les enfants. Donc, nous sommes allés dans la partie de son appartement.
It was a really informal evening, and it was very important that, because it was just at that crucial moment when we had to be on the same wavelength.
Alors, j'ai dit à Tony Blair qu'il fallait faire une dernière tentative de nature politique par les Européens, qui étaient les premiers responsables de la situation dans cette partie de l'Europe.
The consequence of these threats is so serious in terms of the military action. For goodness sake, let's give it another try with the political processes. Stick the people together, you know, get all the pressure we can on both sides to come around the table and try and sort it out.
The President and Prime Minister agreed that the Europeans must take the Milosevic crisis in hand. They decided to ask Serbs and Albanians to a conference, which the British and French foreign ministers would chair.
We took the view that if we could get both sides together, as it happened at Dayton, and make sure that they were obliged to confront each other and to confront these difficult questions, we might achieve the breakthrough.
They invited the parties to the Chateau of Rambouillet, 30 miles from Paris, which Louis XVI had used as his hunting lodge. But who would turn up? The Kosovar Albanian delegation arrived, among them a poet, a newspaper editor, and seven men from the KLA. But as the delegates assembled for the French president's welcoming address, there was someone missing from the Serb delegation, Slobodan Milosevic. When the invitation reached Belgrade, he had consulted a few close colleagues.
To je najveće bilo, či on je već bio faktički kući, da je ceo Rambouillet, već tada je rekao da je ceo Rambouillet smišljen kao opravdanje za početak agresije, da mi imamo mali prostor da tu reku ne prođemo i da se spasimo, da ne dođe do bombardovanja Jugoslavije i da ako je taj mali prostor, treba ga učiniti, evo i da Milutinović ode u Rambouillet.
By sending the president of Serbia as his stand-in, Milosevic left himself room for maneuver. But soon after the conference began, the Serbs learned that the Western leaders insisted any settlement must be policed by NATO troops.
Da trupe NATO-a mogu bez ikakve restrikcije ići kroz celu teritoriju Jugoslavije, da mogu bez naknade ulaziti i izlaziti, bez carine, bez pregleda, bez sudske odgovornosti, da mogu bez naknade koristiti sve naše vojne kapacitete itd. itd. I naravno, ja sam reagovao da taj deo sporazuma je za nas na takav način neprihvatljiv.
That evening, as the American negotiator briefed his Secretary of State in her suite, he received a note.
I got a message that Milutinović wanted to meet with me in the Bristol Hotel, in the piano bar.
Normalno je da na takvim konferencijama mora ostati jedan istorijski trag. Piano baru, znate kako, svira muzika, pa sve lakše.
The Serb wanted privacy to pursue Milosevic's pet idea. Ever since he had lunched with world leaders in Paris, he had harbored a secret ambition. Now it was revealed.
Ja sam rekao, Chris, najbolje budem u NATO.
I said, Milan, I think you've misunderstood something, but go on.
Sam tu bio vrlo precizan. Ali da to bude normalan ugovor kao što imate sa drugim zemljama, NATO zemljama, komercijalni ugovor.
Milan, we don't have years. We're talking weeks, we're talking days. This has got to move ahead.
Hilje ima više jedan stav, otprilike, Ma Milane, pa što ste zapili toliko za tim Kosovom? Pa to je jedna crna rupa, šta će vam to? Bolje se oslobodite te bede.
I said, Milan, I'm telling you, there is a point at which we could find NATO in action against your country.
U redu, evo, ja vam predlažem ovo oko NATO, a ako vi mislite da treba još nešto da razgovarate, razgovarajte sa gospodinom Miloševićem.
It was Mrs. Albright who called Belgrade.
I placed a call to Milosevic and I explained to him what the stakes were. And once again, I did, you're at a fork in the road and you have an option to come back and be a part of Europe. This is a very serious time. You need to consider what's been offered here.
Bezbednostnih snaga Ujedinjenih nacija da koriste sve puteve, luke, aerodrome I teritoriju bez ikakvih ograničenja. Što je značilo praktično okupaciju zemlje.
Mrs. Albright got the rebuff she expected. She put more effort into winning over the Kosovo-Albanian delegation. She needed them to sign up to the contact group's terms, or she would never win approval for action against Milosevic. She focused her attention on the young KLA man who had become delegation leader, Hashim Thaçi.
He presented his perspective about democracy and multi-ethnic cultures and seemed to be wise beyond his years and acted like a leader. You know, he looks like a leader. He's a very tall, handsome young man, quite urbane looking.
Takimin që kishë më darës, në fillimi është programuar për 5 minuta, zjatë e rrëth 25 minuta gjysëmore, e diskutuam për domosdoshmërinë e zgjidhjes politike.
Mrs. Albright was confident that she would accept the terms on offer, even though they promised Kosovo only autonomy within Serbia, not the independence the KLA was fighting for. But she didn't realize the pressure the KLA leader was under from home.
We came more on telephone, Jeff, on top of the group in the negotiator, Chen Konata. Edhe ju kemi kërcënuar se nuk guxoni më në shkruaj.
Por edhe në Kosovë është krijuar një opinion se gjaja atje delegacioni shqiptar është duke tratuar.
Më kujtohet se sot kur njëunit prej tyre I kam thonë se ju e dini se kemi raketa kundër ajrit dhe do t'i ruajmë ato raketa, do t'i përdorim më sër po aeroplanin e ju po zbritën Slatin do ta rrezojmë nëse në shkruani.
The KLA were demanding a referendum on independence, certain that the Albanian majority would vote for it. After 2 weeks of hard bargaining, the foreign ministers arrived for the final session. They summoned each delegation in turn.
The foreign ministers all sat at a long table, as if we were in judgment or something. And first Thaçi was brought in with a couple of other members of the Albanian delegation.
Kishte ardhur momenti që ne të themi thjesht po ose jo dokumentit, gjë që me të vërtetë ishte mjaft e rëndë.
The question was basically, do you agree with the framework, yes or no? And we were expecting a yes, or I was.
Dokumenti ishte kundër pavarësisë, nuk përfshihej referendumi, por një të kohë gjë për cilën edhe kishin luftuar, shumë njerëz kishin vrarë, shumë njerëz. Përgjigja ime ka qenë, ne në shkruajmë dokumentin, por në dokument duhet përfshihet referendumi.
He needed further improvements, and of course the improvements he wanted were ones that we knew were unnegotiable, they were impossible to get agreement on. And eventually I had to say to him, look, the bottom line here, the real question is, can you say yes to this package?
Ishte një situatë e rrezikshme për ne, posaçërisht nga se dini, ministri italian insistot në të nazinte për çdo fjalë dhe bënte këtë me mjeshtri.
Io dissi che su questo ci voleva, come Robin Cook, ci voleva una risposta chiara. Chiara e netta, che era sì o era no.
Dhe dija se po që se ne je themi jo këti dokumenti, ne do të humbisnim mbështetjen ndërkombëtare, problemi Kosovës do të qitej në harres, ky problem do të kurdizoj.
He kept kind of moving around the issue, and when he wouldn't say yes, I remember taking off my earphones, just putting them down on the table in just pure exasperation.
She didn't like in particolare la mia insistenza di conoscere esattamente qual era la posizione kosovara.
I thought that the way that the language had been constructed provided what in diplomacy we call some creative ambiguity.
E io ho detto, certamente una certa ambiguità nella fraseologia che si mette negli accordi è necessaria, ma qui si decideva se bombardare o non bombardare la Serbia, che era una decisione di una tale importanza che dovevamo essere assolutamente certi che la responsabilità del mancato accordo era della Serbia e che non era dei kosovari.
And Dini got more and more insistent and said, are you willing to give up independence?
Tha që ajo nuk mund të pranojmë edhe atë rukthy ka Madeleine Albright tha, you see, this is what I told you. And, nuk I tha kështu me fjalë, mirë po shikimi ishte, you see, I told you so.
Madeleine Albright s'est montrée à la fois surprise et très préoccupée. Elle a demandé une suspension de séance. Nous avons suspendu la séance, on a discuté, tout le monde a parlé à tout le monde.
Okay. Ma c'era grande nervosismo nella delegazione americana perché la strategia che gli americani avevano portato avanti e sviluppato era fallita.
For the cameras, Mrs. Albright stuck to her usual line.
The Serb delegation bears the lion's share of responsibility for the difficulties we have experienced today.
But in private, with Hashim Thaci, she took a different tack.
I said, look, I don't understand what just happened in there. You have let us down. It is an impossible situation now. How could you do this? We expected you to be a leader.
Doni Albright ka deklaruar se, po që se ju në nëshkruni, Serbet nuk në nëshkruin, ne do të bombardojmë. Ne do të aktivizohemi. Po që se ju nuk nënshkruni, Serbet e pranojnë, ne kemi duart e lidhura.
You could see that he was just shocked. I mean, he looked like a high school student that I had dressed down.
Edhe të nesërmen, është rritur presioni që të pranojnë atë dokument pa referendum.
The Kosovo Albanians were given 3 more days. They wanted to sign, but they were still under pressure from the gunmen back home. For 72 hours, they did not leave the castle or go to bed. As the deadline approached, the delegation was still arguing. Then the American negotiator went to their room.
I said, guys, we're there now. We've got 5 minutes now to really decide this thing.
The Chris Hilli mriti I tëri I djersitur, kravata e hapur, s'kishte fjet aqsa disa prej nesh.
I said, so are you going to sign this thing or are you not? At that point, Saroy spoke up.
Këto 2 javë, 3 javë po I kalojmë negociata. Këto 10 vjet po I kalojmë konflikt me Milošević. Edhe po vjen një moment, I vetëmi moment, kur krejt këto po mundemi me gjujt, edhe jemi të gjujt. Edhe për mu ka qenë sekondat të cilat ne po e gjujm krejt mundin ton, vetëm se nuk mund të gjejmë një formulim shumë të thjesht.
Veton Saroy had a brainwave. The document they were being asked to sign said, in 3 years, an international meeting would consider a final settlement for Kosovo, and the will of the people would be taken into account. Saroy suggested they could sign it if Mrs. Albright accepted a letter stating that the will of the people would be tested in a referendum.
Pra, faktikisht e cilnim derën për një lloj referendumi politik, por njëkohësisht I thoshim bashkisë ndërkombëtare se sa I përket nesh puna me këtë dokument ka përfunduar.
Thaci was trying to read the draft on his translator's computer screen.
And I have Jim O'Brien and Jamie Rubin behind, telling me, hurry up, man, hurry up. He can read it later.
And Hashim was saying, well, maybe you could change that. And I said, no, no, you can't change. And I began to step in front of him and sort of bump him back away from the computer. I want it done.
And Thaci becomes tremendously nervous. He says, you're not leaving this chair until I get both wordings in both languages.
Kemi pritur shumë kohë, kemi seduar shumë gjatë, dhe një minutë nuk do të na kushtoj asgjë.
O'Brien just takes a sheet of paper, knowing that if the paper remains a few more minutes in Thatcher's possession, he would probably change his mind.
I said, Jamie, here's a copy. You're going to announce this.
I thought that I better first check with the Secretary of State, and I snuck into the conference room and whispered in her ear what had happened, and she said, go out and announce it.
The letter was addressed to Mrs. Albright, so she was able to accept the referendum compromise without consulting her colleagues.
Then I really started to get my blood pumping, and I began running through the halls of this crazy castle and out through the gates and into the town square to finally tell the reporters something good.
Very briefly, the Kosovo-Albanian delegation has voted in favor of this agreement, pending consultations with the people of Kosovo.
The Albanians had chosen peace and deferred independence, and the Serbs had not, and now there was clarity that the world needed in deciding whose side they should be on.
With a referendum in the bag, Thatcher won over the commanders back home. The delegation returned to Paris for the signing ceremony. Milosevic stayed home, claiming foul play.
What was tried to be imposed in Rambouillet was not autonomy at all. That was independence. And I really don't believe, if you show it to any honest American, that there is one single honest American who will tell you that if they were on the place of our delegation, could sign that.
Serbia's parliament duly backed Milosevic's rejection of the Rambouillet terms, as did the Serb public. Serbia's deputy prime minister revealed what Milosevic was planning to do next.
Ako dođe do bombardovanja od strane NATO pakta, ako dođe do američke agresije, mi Srbi ćemo prilično stradati, ali Albanaca na Kosovu neće biti.
Nationalism had brought Milosevic to power. Now, it threatened to bring about his downfall.
And this series continues next week on BBC Two at the same time.